I don't have to trim too much up here. When I threw it, I kept the thickness about that wide, which is just fine. Takes a steady hand and a few muscles. The operative word is few there. We're just going to keep doing this until we get close to that drain plug that through last time. If this was a sink that was going to stand up rather than being self-rimming, then I would slip the outside too. There's no need to slip the outside particularly, since it's going to be in this particular sink under the counter. No hurry with trimming. I would generally put my hand on the inside, but I got a bunch of wet slip in there, so I can't do it. Using a little sharper tool here. The advantage of having it dry real slow for 5 days in this case is that the clay is uniformly wet all the way through. It's not like dry on the outside and wet on the inside, which you'll find was, if you dry it fast. And what I'm trying to do is just mirror the inside with the outside. I know some people stick a needle through to see how thick it is. I couldn't possibly do that because that hole would remain. Actually, it remains anytime you do it. So I just kind of got to look with my eyes and see. Take a little off up here, it's a little thick up here. And before I go too much further, I'm going to go ahead and make sure I got a good seat right here so when this pot sets on the counter, it works. See how dry this clay is? That's still pretty wet. Now with a good carpenter, you only need about a quarter of an inch. If your carpenter says you need more, hire a new carpenter. cutting into the play. And cutting under it. Now down here, the clay is going to be a little bit wetter, so I could actually ball it up. That's pretty much what I can do right here. I'm going to flip it over and trim a little more.